Okay, let's see our doors in here. I think they are great, maybe. They are okay. What the heck, man? Where are my doors? Boss?
Hi, Javad is here, and let's learn how we can bring those windows back, and that's the way that we use ViewRange. ViewRange is the way that we see our plans. As you know, the sections are our vertical sections, but we have plans that they are horizontal sections from our buildings. And in those plans, we consider a view range. In view range, we have a top part, cut plane, bottom part, and the view depth part. In this episode, we can learn how we use these settings in different views.
Now you know the basics of view range. To get access to the view range of each view that you have, you need to press VR, or in the properties palette, you can go to the view range, and here you can access to the view range. In view range, as I said, we have three main parts. We have primary range, which has cut plane and top range and bottom range. And also we have a view depth in here that will allow us to specify another line type for that area. To understand it better, we have a door in plan and in section that we have in here. And let's go to the view range of this plan again. And in VR, you can see the bottom part is level 1 and the top part is level 1, but the cut plane is about 130, something about in here, in section. Let's put it on a bigger number, maybe 25. And when I click on apply, it will give me an error, and you need to know that the top part always need to be upper or at the same level that your cut plane is. For example, let's copy it, and or maybe let's put this one on a bigger number, and let's click on apply. And now you can see the cut plane is something like in here, and you can see your walls at this view range, and that's the reason. Or in vice versa situation, maybe you would change the placement of your door or your window, and then you will see that your door or window is disappearing, and that's the reason that you don't see them. But there is a thing you need to know, that some categories are not cuttable. For example, this furniture that we have in here, they are not cuttable. So when you change your view range, it doesn't make any sense, and they don't change. So they are not cuttable. To understand about the cuttable and uncuttable categories, to know which one is cuttable and which one is uncuttable in Revit, you need to go to the Manage tab and Object Style, and in here you can see there are families that they are categories that they don't have any cut line weight parameter. They are uncuttable, so you can see which category is uncuttable in your Revit project. As I said, in Revit we have a view depth part, we have a primary range and view depth range. In this view range, this is the possibility to see some other things beyond of our primary range, but with a different line type that we'll talk about the line type of it later. But you need to know that the view depth level needs to be at the same level to bottom line or under it, or as you can see in the view, it needs to be in here or it needs to be under the bottom line. So make sure to know about that.
Maybe you've got confused and you don't know what's the difference between underlay and view range in Revit. Each of them has their own usage and they are different. Let's learn the difference of them.
For example, in this view, let's try underlay in this part. Click on underlay, and in here, let's put maybe entry level. And you can see some elements that are underlay. These are all underlay elements that you can see in here. You can change the selection of them or the ability of selection of them. From in here, select underlay elements in this part. And also, they haven't been cut. For example, when you have a wall and this is in view range, they are cut and you can see the layers of it. But when a wall is in underlay, it's just the way that you can see them. They haven't been cut. So that's the difference, another difference between underlay and view range. And also in underlay, you can look above, and there is another difference that they have. As I said, when we are working with view depth part or other than the primary range of Revit, there is a ability to change the line style of that part. For example, let's put the view depth on unlimited to see all of the elements under this part, and let's put it on maybe hidden line, and let's go to the manage, and in here additional setting, and in line styles we have a line style which is beyond, and we need to change the beyond. Let's put it on red, and let's put it on maybe hidden or center, and click on OK. As you can see, and the elements that are in view depth range, they are in another line style, so you can see them, but at the same time you can understand they are in view depth range.
Despite of plans, you can see weird behaviors from view range in sailing plan. This is a little bit different. We don't have any bottom line, and also we have view depths at the top of our top line, and let's learn the difference between them.
The behavior of view range in sailing is a little bit different. You have a cut plane and you have a top, but in this part the view depth doesn't work at the bottom of it, it works at the top of it. So when you want to assign your view depths, it needs to be upper than the top line or at the same level of the top line. So for example, I need to place it at the top of it, and also I have a cut plane. Let's put it on maybe it is great, and for the top level let's put it on the thing it is, and for the view depths let's put it on unlimited. Click on OK, and now we can see the lines that are in view depth range are in different style because we've changed the beyond line style.
In some specific situation and some models, for example, you want a view range for your whole plan, but you need another view range, and in one area you need another view range. You don't need to create a new plan for it. You can use plan region tool to specify a specific view range for a specific range of your plan.
To use plan region, you need to go to the view tab, and in here we have a plan view, and click on it and go to the plan region, and now you can create your boundary, for example in this part. And the beauty of a plan region is that you can create you can assign different view range for this part, and also you can move it. That's great, guys. Click on view range and you can assign in a different view range, for example 3000, and let's paste it in here, and now we have different view range in this part, and you can see different elements that you are not able to see before that, and you can assign different view range to multiple places.
In some situations, when we bring link files in Revit, we need to have we need to see view range for link file, and we can control the view range of our link file by host view or by the link file. Let's learn how we can configure it.
To change the view range of your link file separately from your main file, click on VG, and in the Revit link part, click on by host view, and let's put it on custom. And first of all, you need to assign which views are linked to the exact level that you are seeing. For example, let's put it on floor 1, and then in view range part you can specify that you want to control your view range by your host model or your main model or by your link model. You can change it from in here. You can put it on linked file or main file, and it will be different. As you see, it is different, and also you can change the link view to it. And this was a session from my Revit architecture beginner course. I will put the playlist in here. Make sure to go there and check that and learn Revit, and also introduce it to your friends.